Hey, welcome, 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 welcome. We have Suja in the house here. Sweet little Suja in the house. What I'm doing here is I'm going to go crazy. I shouldn't have shaken that up, should I? I don't know what I'm doing. I bought all this, this organic health food at Whole Foods, and I'm going to open it up, and I'm going to show you what's going on, what I'm going to be slamming tomorrow morning. In fact, I might even slam it here tonight. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm giving you the ambience of the rain here is what I'm doing. This is a new recording technique. I'm just trying it out. You know, I'm just experimenting. It's exhausting because you don't know what's going to happen. I think this is going to explode on me. Oh, it did it. So, let me read the ingredients. This is Suja, water lemon red cabbage, organic and cold pressed, honey, macai berry, cool, calm, collected stevia, vanilla, lavender, vegetable and fruit juice drink, man. Suja Lavinade, it's called. Suja Lavinade. Let me just lavinate this for a little while. Let me see. Oh, wow. Ah, it's the stevia that kind of messes it up, actually. Why did they put stevia in? Forget it. I don't need the stevia. Only 1 gram of sugar. I'd rather have the sugar than the stevia. Stevia messes it up. Two thumbs down. That one. Don't put stevia in stuff, you know? Why? This next one. I think this is like crazy. It's called Blueprint Organic Watercress Warrior. Watercress Warrior. Watercress, kale, spinach, cucumber, celery, lemon. Raw vegetable and fruit drink. Let's just hope. Hope it doesn't have stevia in it. Man. Natural peppermint flavor. Okay. Well, I gotta be careful about this. Uh-oh, that could have caused a problem. Man. It's all new, so I'm a little bit nervous about this. Okay, so. Here we go. This is the watercress. I'm now watercress warrior. I'm going about to be. That's horrible. That's really horrible. That's like the worst drink I've ever tasted. Are you kidding me? You know how much these things cost? I got them on sale. That's why I grabbed them. Maybe they're on sale because no one was buying them. Golly, that has got to be a mixer. Don't drink that straight. Don't drink that straight. That's horrible. But now I'm a watercress warrior. This week, Good Belly Probiotics. Good Belly Probiotics. And this one is triple berry protein shake. 15 grams of plant-powered protein. 40 billion probiotic cultures. This should be really good. I'm looking forward to this. After the Watercress Warrior one, anything is going to taste great, as a matter of fact. So I have no fear at this point. I survived that one. The rest is butter. That's really good. That's good. Good belly. That's what I'm looking for, is a good belly these days. Gone is the toad belly. Oh, yeah. I can get into that. That's actually really good. So, we have a leader in the clubhouse here. But now we're getting into some exotic territory. This. Gotta beware of these cables. Cable beware. Let me put this over somewhere. Okay. Vita Columbia Gorge Organic Cold Pressed Vita C Superfoods. I'm not gonna even say it. I don't even know what's in here. It's spirulina, sea algae, grasses, strawberry, lush bananas and mangoes with blended with apples, peaches, and pears. So it's spirulina and chlorella RA algae. Most powerful of the green superfoods, sea lettuce, dulse, and kelp. Gluten-free alfalfa, barley, and wheat grasses. Harvested before gluten is produced in the plant. Oh, that's really important. And providing 200 milligrams each of additional green goodness. I said, this is just a killer drink here. Okay. I've got my macho drink attitude on here. Come on. Cheers. I think. What is this? I'm kind of scared right now. Looking at it. It looks like oil. What is this? Car oil? Wow. First time I've ever had algae. Gosh, it tastes weird. And spirulina and chlorina and... I hope I don't turn into a Martian tonight. Oh, good Lord. Not bad. It just has got this little sea taste to it. Kinda. It's a little weird. I know it's algae, maybe not from the sea. But, okay, now we're getting into Odwalla. Some Odwalla goodness. Original superfood, fruit smoothie, blend of apple, peach, mango, banana. Oh, this is just straight on fruit, I guess. Crack this open, belly up to the bar, and here we go. Wow, what's in here? I mean, it's got something. Oh, yeah. 1,850 milligrams of spirulina and 50 milligrams of kale. So they hide it with all this fruit juice. It's green goodness in here. Living the life of green goodness, man. So I saw these on sale, like $2 off at Whole Foods. I never go into Whole Foods, except this time I did it as a treat for someone to grab something. I saw this and I said, hey, you know what? It's now or never, right? Let's take the dive. Let's jump in. Just, and see if we fly. You know, we gotta fly, we might as well try some, you know, some green goodness fuel, right? To start flying. I mean, of course, if I'm enlightened tonight, people will know exactly why. They'll have to mix all these different drinks together, and just the amount that I drank, right? And I say, okay, so like the next 1,000 years, people will be like blending all these drinks, and maybe this is the drink that'll do it. Protein, naked protein and greens mixture here. What's this one got? It's got apples, kiwi, pineapple, banana, mango. So far, so good. I'm feeling pretty good about this one. Let's see. 30 grams whey and soy protein. That's great. Oh, alfalfa, barley grass. Broccoli? Oh, that's right there. I'm off of this one. Kale, parsley, spinach, spirulina, wheatgrass. It's the broccoli. I don't want to taste broccoli juice. Had before and it just about killed me. Oh, man. That's not so good. That's not so good. Mm. So I've got, since I opened all these, I've got to drink them all the next couple days. It's this one, the berry probiotics. This is really good. It's probably got a lot of sugar, right? Check the sugar, 19 grams, of course. That's it, 19 grams of sugar. Berry chaser, need a berry chaser. Actually need a chocolate chaser for all this stuff. Good Lord. Go back to the water lemon and red cabbage. What lemonade? Stevia, this is horrible. Suja, it tastes like plastic and stevia. Come on. And it's very expensive. You gotta do better, Suja. That's terrible. But nothing compared to the watercress. I mean, we could go out and pick some weeds and blend them and juice them and it would taste better. Seriously. I mean, I think they did that, actually. I think there's some folks up there somewhere, you know, just like with their John Deere mower, just with a bag and just bagging everything they mow and then just throwing it in some juicer and calling it good. I don't know what else to say. Maybe they throw in some watercress, you know? I'm just joking, but taste-wise, it tastes like weeds. Ugh, that's horrible. So there's my taste test. Actually, believe it or not, I used to, when I had my recorder long ago, I used to make all these recordings. It was amazing to just amuse my dad, I think. He had some health problems. But it was before that even, but I would just include all these lists of stuff that I was saying, oh, this is great, I love this, and make these recordings. They were really amazing. So I'm actually, this, I'm in the comfort zone about just bring it on. Oh, let me try this. I just buy all these samples of all this stuff and then just go through them all. You know, just amazing. Make a recordings of that. And so we have here, we have good old what? Chaser H2O. That's the best right there. That's the winner. H2O. Distilled H2O. Charcoal filtered distilled H2O. That's what I like. So speaking of H2O, we're out here just waiting for the rain. I mean, they're supposed to rain like 2.5 inches today, and it's just kind of like sprinkled, you know. Again, they botched this, the forecast. Or maybe it'll all come at once over the next 24 hours. I hope so. I hope we get about 20 inches, actually. But it doesn't look like it. So I may have some problems sleeping tonight. Not from the rain, although there's supposed to be intense thunderstorms, so it might wake us up. It may just come down tonight. It may pour tonight. I hope so. But these drinks, I mean, they weren't nearly as good as I was hoping. I was hoping for the price. You know, what are they, like $6? I mean, they go up to $7, $8, $7.99, $5.99. I got the $5.99s for like $3.99, and the $7.99s for $5.99. Come on. Whole Foods, whole paycheck. I mean, just once in a lifetime. I don't think I'm going to miss any of this stuff. Oh, my stomach doesn't feel good already. So, anyway, what we do for the intensive, this is what we do. I mean, we do everything. There's nothing we don't do, right? It's true. It's intensive means you go for it, okay? You go for it. Intensive doesn't mean you hold back and say, oh, I don't know. Intensive says, you know what? I'm going to try to fly. That's the intensive. You're going to try to fly. And you're going to get airborne, you know, one way or the other, you're going to get airborne. So we need to get airborne this year. I'm already airborne, actually. This green goodness is bringing me down. That's what I do to come down and re-enter the insanity of the world. As I go to Whole Foods and grab a bunch of these bottles of this crazy cabbage, you know, lavender juice. And yeah, that'll bring me back down to earth. Make me think I'm in a world. How is this video? How is it sounding? I don't know. I don't have earphones on. I could though. I could. Let me see. All right. Hey. So how is this video sounding? Oh, sounding terrible. Too much reverb. But I'm in a kind of reverb state of mind because this stuff here is reverberating through my psyche. So maybe I'll get a visitation tonight from E.T. Most likely. It'd be better than the dreams I've been having. That's for sure. I've been having some bad ones. Political assassinations. I had a dream a couple of days, nights ago. It was really sick. It was crazy. I said, what is going on in this world? I mean, yeah, business as usual here. I mean, so forget about the world. Forget about the world. The world is terrible. Can I do this? Forget about the world. The world is terrible. Anyway, this is the mic I'm using, my little new Tascam recorder, and I'm going directly into it, so it's probably loud now. Probably just clipped the recording right there. I'm sure I did. Can I do this? Okay. But it's a limited recorder, actually. I mean, that's all I really wanted to do. I just wanted to fool around, carry it with me. I can record anywhere I want to. I can hook up external mics to it, two of them. I don't know why I do that, but I mean, I could get a couple of, mics and diaphragm mics or I don't know, XLR inputs and then run them somewhere and get ambient sound. I don't know why I want to do anything like that, but mostly it's just, I practiced karaoke today and it was terrible. I lost the top end of my voice, dropped out after I was trying to do Dion, Teenager in Love or something, and one of the songs, Why Do Fools Fall in Love, I had to keep going up higher and higher, and my voice just vanished. I was nervous and just feeling weird, not used to singing that way. I was doing karaoke with a backing track from YouTube going into the recorder, then mixing it with my voice on the internal microphones here. And, you know, the voice sounded great, except I lost all my high end, and I don't know how to sing without the high end. I'm used to being able to get up to that high end and reach all the notes there. And just poof, gone. Gone! I can actually raise the volume of this. Well, I think, can I do that while I'm recording? I don't think so. Let me see. I don't know. Input. Not really. It's on recording standby. I cannot really mess with the levels right now. But anyway, it's recording onto the disc. It's not recording onto this little deck. It's actually recording to a memory chip in the computer. And so the karaoke session was a disaster. I just couldn't sing. So I said, well, stop. Mama said there'll be days like this. And stop. And next time, I'll be all over it for sure. But, you know, very humbly, I said, uh-oh, I got some work to do. The voice wasn't there. I was clipping the notes. I was going flat. I was just, you know, was not quite in the ballpark. Okay, but low expectations. Start with low expectations. I like that. Wonderful. So I've been doing some things on a YouTube, a Facebook, not on YouTube, Facebook. changing the cover photo and changing the profile photo and stuff. And the Holy Spirit wants me to go for it. Says, you know what? You want to go for it? Then get going for it. Because what people need is silence. They need to realize there's someone who's going to try and help them out at some point with maybe some silence, something. And so someone's standing up and saying, okay, I raised my hand and said, okay, I'm in. Dharma Kings, I'm in. Let's get with the program. And so they said, well, then put your face up there. And I said, no. Everybody in the world is loyal to absurdity, actually. That's true. Again, everyone minus, okay? And so silence is the best way to go, because that way it prevents people from putting their foot in their mouths and making fools of themselves, and it's no good. I they go up to the satsang, whatever. I just think that silence is probably the best way to go. And then people can let their attention settle down without thinking, okay, what do I need to say? I need to... The guru asked me a question and said, how do you feel? I said, well, guru, I've been working hard in my meditation. And he said, oh, really? Who's meditation? Who's meditating? Yeah. Oh, okay. Well, I don't know. Maybe for some that works. But what we're getting at is more profound than this. More profound. Okay, this is Dharma King territory. And so to opt into to a Dharma King, pre-intent, to say I will help with an intensive in 218, is really just uncharted territory, like for me. So I'm just having to go with the flow. So I'm putting like my face, my head up. From a YouTube video and a nice background picture, and Sky Pilot is there, giving people a heads up, like, I'm going to try and see what I can do. And so just, like a 12-year-old, so just put up with me, because I'm in uncharted territory. I'm just kind of going to have to feel my way forward, being very 12 years old. They're very good at that, right? They're very good at managing to very athletic and flexible and sharp and bright and all this stuff. So I'll dial it in one way or the other and just keep innovating here and keep every day pushing forward with, various things. And, be ready to answer the bell in 218. What a bell it's going to be. Everybody's going to take a tumble. There's a nasty little... What's going to happen is a weird trip is coming. A very weird trip. Very weird trip. And people are going to take a tumble. And I'll be there saying, get back on your feet, everything's fine. But we don't need to talk about it, but let's be quiet together. It's okay. We can get to that. We can get to that. I could say a few things, but by and large we can get to this stillness, this eloquence, this really silence is just allowing yourself to be truly eloquent. Okay? Allow yourself to be truly eloquent. Allow yourself to be truly eloquent. Boom! Maybe I should get closer. Allow yourself to get truly eloquent. Or maybe just go silent. Go back at this. But anyway, silence is allowing yourself to be truly eloquent. Because you're not making any mistakes, are you? And it's all beyond words anyway, right? So that's true eloquence. We can do it. Excuse me, that's the watercress coming up. Ah, I don't want to burp after what I went through. Are you kidding me? That just brings the bad memories up. Leave the bad memories down in the stomach. Come on. That was terrible. That was worse than I thought. I don't know what I'm thinking. Got myself into trouble. Just took a little tumble right there. Into the cabbage patch. But we have this beautiful rain. Rain down, rain down. Rain down your love on your people. See, I got no voice. See, I can't. People, rain down, Rain down your love on us all. Terrible. No voice. Gone. But that's because I've been taping so much too, and I, my cold, my throat, it's just... But I'm still in the ballgame, right? I don't give up. I say, that's okay. That's okay. Now, been absolutely crushing balance work today. I'm starting to bring it all together. I said, let's go for it, and I'm going for it. So be of good cheer, encouraged by this. Feel encouraged that there's somebody out there in the playing field to say, you know what? Standing out there on the playing field and say, you know, okay, I got this. So I broke out the Bosu ball and was just hammering this in so many ways I've never done before. I mean, it's just intense. My knee's actually hurting, sore from it. And then I brought the 36-inch foam roller. Never tried that before, 4-inch, and was walking back and forth on it, and that was really cool. So just the ab rocket workout, everything, just hammering it. The thing that I push out in front of me for the abs, I did that a bunch. So my body, my core, I feel just like I did a day's work. But I'm never content. I'm never content with the day, the work that I did in the day. I always want more. Okay, so this is a great attitude to have. Always want more. Want to be, you know, go even further. As I lay down to go to sleep, I'm not ready to go to sleep. I say, no, let me just give it like that. Let me lay here for like an hour and just meditate and focus in. And I wake up at 4 in the morning. I said, let me give 4 hours of meditation. And then I get up and just push all through the day. It's just never, it never stops. It never stops. But how can it stop when we're headed for such a crisis? Trying to deify commotion, confusion, uncertainty, right? Panic, fear. Trying to deify all of that as, you know, as if that will sanctify us. This is stupid. It's so stupid, and when you try to deify all that, you're going to get in big trouble. You're going to take a tumble. I've been through it. There's no question about it. If you go down that pathway, I just wanted to see, you know, what's it all about? What's going on? Let me try it out. I found out. I found out, and I'm here to say, maybe you shouldn't do that too. Still alive and well. Well, I wasn't very well. When you try to deify confusion, you're going to end up with mental mess. Okay, really. So, but it's okay because you can get out of it. Okay, you get out of it. The dharma evaporates your karma. Got to speak up here. It's raining. I'm used to this little mic right here. I got to talk like have a voice. Which I don't have a voice right now. I know the tumble, so you can get out of it. You can get out of it. You can get out of it. You will get out of it. Everyone will, eventually. But just, you know, hammer your good habits for a year. I mean, just go for it. And this is my sincerest advice, and it's always a great time to go for it, okay? There's never a time in this world where it's not a super great time to just go for it, okay? So that right there should be enough for everyone. But, you know, I'm just giving them this extra push, saying it's just essential to go for it, because we are really, the world is... we're up against it. We're up against a false belief in a world. And everything that goes with it. The world that goes with the world is just going to whirl us, everyone, into mental confusion. Mental chaos. And of course, people will be popping pharmaceuticals. It'll be the biggest bonanza for the pharmaceutical industry imaginable. But maybe some of you say, you know what? Let me keep working my good habits. And let me see if we can't ease into some silent sitting and start getting the flow of that. I tried to contact Sri Sri Anandamayi Ma, the Queen of Wow, today, and this evening. And right away, in my mind, this, I said, okay, I'll contact you. I'll see you as a 10-year-old or 8-year-old, 10-year-old, just a little girl, a young girl like that. And right away, she appeared in my mind's eye, just boom. And the clothes that she was wearing, that was so astonishing. I just thought, whoa, never seen anything like it. So I feel that really was her, because I couldn't have imagined the type of clothing, the style. It's just so different than anything I've ever seen. And her body was just all dark, blackish, almost like a silhouette. It was really almost like looking at a silhouette, but the clothes showed accents of color, like goldenish color, orangish golden color. And there she was, but as just a little girl, and she was so happy to be there. She was so happy I invited her. Seriously, just invite the Dharma Kings. But a great one is Sri Sri Ananda Maya Ma, because invite her as a little girl just to come visit you. And she wants to do is just sit there, and just look at you. She's so happy. She's so thrilled just to see you, that you asked her to come see you. But you gave her permission. You know, come and view me. You have the right to just come and view me. Isn't that amazing? I'll keep trying that. I'll keep trying. This is a completely different approach to the gurus, isn't it? They're really just asking us permission to see us. And we keep saying, no, guru, I'm not ready for you yet. What do you mean? We think that we're supposed to come see them. It's the opposite. They want to see us. They love us. We won't allow them into our presence, you know? It's like, what if you had this adorable child and you refuse to let the child ever see you as a parent? You know, how would that child feel? Think about that. You have this just wonderful child who's just so adorable, and she just loves you so much, the parents. But you keep her in the room and you never let her out, and you refuse to let her see you. And year after year after year, that's how it is. Just imagine how crazy that is, you know, right? Just think of the anguish. Just bringing this scenario up, just feel the anguish of that. Of the child can't even see you. What do you allow it? And your anguish too. So this is crazy. I've got to let the child see me. Just then transfer this whole scenario over to the guru. So aren't you going to open that door and say, okay, you can see me? And you've been keeping her in the dark there the whole time, you think. But the guru is never in the dark. Their own light is always there. So we think that, oh my gosh, I've kept her in this dungeon for so long. But this little child is going to be rotted. There's going to be a corpse when I open the door. But when you open the door, no. She's sweetly smiling there. Said, oh, thank you. So I get to see you. This is such a treat for me. So she's not all messed up. You think, oh, she probably has mental problems, being locked up in a dark room all this time. No, the guru is self-luminous. The guru has been in absolute bliss the whole time, but still pining to see you, but they're not messed up at all. But we can understand how we're afraid they might be, right? Because we've been keeping them. So the guru is our self. We've been refusing to let the self, you know, really see itself, so to speak. So just let it happen. I got kind of like, oh my gosh, she's there. That was shocked me. I'll keep trying. It's time to go for it, isn't it? We can't hold back anymore. It's time to pull out all the stops. open up 360 degrees. That's why I've got this microphone here, so it can catch the ambience, okay? And just let it all in. Let's let it all happen right now. That mixture was just terrible. I think if I chugged all this stuff, I would be mega sick. I'm not sure algae's good for me. Oh no, how am I gonna sleep tonight? Oh well, I'll just stay awake and call for an anima to come see me. I say, it's okay, you can come see me now. I just drank algae tonight, I'll be okay. Settles my mind, the algae and the spirulina, especially. Maybe that's what's wrong with everybody. And that's what, they're drinking all the spirulina and stuff and algae. I wonder why they're messed up. Maybe it does something to the brain cells. You know, something's wrong, right? Well, yeah. Trying to sanctify ourselves. That's what's wrong. Thin is in. Thin is in. Thin is in. I don't know, maybe I'm going mod. Maybe I'll go mod for 270. I look like an astronaut, kind of. I'm waiting for the heavy rain. Come on. We're here, we got the microphone. Bring it on. I'll take the mic and I'll point it out to the rain and say, come on, let's go. Let it flow. Let it flow. This is just the appetizer, really. So, that's okay. Kind of get things nice and soaked. Get everything running nicely. And then, boom! The atmosphere of the river is supposed to dump. Let's see if it dumps. So, as the days go forward, we're not going to wait. We're not waiting for anything here, okay? We are not waiting for anything. What's going on? How come I go this way? Okay, I see. All right. It's just dark. It's just dark. It's like the world is dark, but we're here. It's just this jacket I'm not used to. It's medium. We had this jacket, and didn't fit me, but I got it back. You know, try this, medium. I said, I can't fit in this. I fit. Barely. But it fits. So from extra large to medium, that's what's happened with me. Extra large to medium. I never thought I'd ever be medium. That's ridiculous. But there I am. Tennis, anyone? Yeah, next thing I'll be playing tennis. Or maybe going to karaoke bars. I doubt that, though. Maybe I sing best when I don't care. Nobody's listening. It doesn't matter. And then like a whole different gear opens up. And It's a whole different scenario. It's a whole different psyche, sort of, at that point. But as soon as you think you're recording something, everything gets strained. Everything gets strained. That's why musicians use drugs. Because as soon as you put on a performance, you start straining everything. And you sing best when you totally have no self-consciousness at all. You're not even thinking about anything. So they use drugs, alcohol, whatever. And they just feel loosey-goosey. And they can just, you know, they can perform better. But I'll just drink the watercress and kale and spinach. That'll do it. That'll do it. Maybe I'll throw up and that'll loosen everything up. Possibly.
Okay.
Digging the scene here. So we'll have a blast in 217. I'm not even here. That's how much fun I'm having. I'm not even here. As Ramana says, here, now is also our imagination. The present moment, he said, is also our imagination. That's true. And nobody tells it like Ramana. The present moment is also our imagination. Yeah. So this is why you would wonder about like the Neo-Advaita and the non-dualists and all this. Do they have it? Not quite. Do they have healed perception? Possibly. You know, they knocking on the door? Possibly. You know, so let's not dismiss it at all. But we can feel and we know they're not quite like Ramana. Okay. So Ramana is just, you know, beyond the present moment, realizing that too is just our imagination. So we need to keep this in mind, and we take a different approach than the Neo-Advaitins and the Neo-Non-Dualists and all this kind of stuff. Not disparaging their approach, but we take a little different approach. Because we feel that getting to the present moment is good. Abiding, abidance there. Abidance is great. But it goes a little deeper than that, actually. So, and we want to, we don't want to get caught up in the non-dual rhetoric of it, okay? We don't get caught up in the Dzogchen rhetoric, actually, either. The last thing Longchenpa wants us to do is say we're Dzogchenists, you know? That's the booby prize. It's not like that. It's not like anything we say. So we could just forget everything, really. It's not like anything. It never will be like anything. It will never be like any explanation. It won't. So, you know, just don't draw any conclusions at all. And that probably the most helpful is just don't draw any conclusions at all. Practice drawing no conclusions. Just full stop in the wow. One conclusion, it's wow. And you hear the great realizers of history. What is it? You know, it's like, you know, bah! They'll be asking the teacher, you know, can you explain it? You know, it's like, you know, just give us the realization. Ah! And we just say, wow. That's what it's like. It's like wow. So just keep on saying it's like wow. It's just wow. It's nothing more than wow. And what is wow? Wow is wow. Wow is wow. Also. Well, can you define wow? Yeah, wow is a definition of wow. Can you give another definition? Absolutely we can. Wow is the other explanation, definition. I got a whole dictionary full of definitions of wow. It's wow, 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 Wow. And that's all it is. And they'll say, well, that's very, you know, very quixotic. No, it's very wowish. The rain's starting to pick up here. Very wowish. Right now. Berry wowish. I think I'll have some more berry stuff. The other stuff I'm not gonna touch. What am I gonna do? I'm gonna bury that in chocolate. Some chocolate almond drink. I got some almond drink. I never tried almond drink. Chocolate almond drink. I think I got. I'll just see if I can bury some of this stuff in that. I don't know. I don't think I'll make a habit. Too expensive anyway, right? What are they kidding me? I got this nice lady in Whole Foods. First time ever that, well, I got this man before I was nice. So two in a row. That's like all-time record at Whole Foods with nice cashiers, right? Where they treat you like you're actually might be a decent human being. Yeah, they actually did. Maybe I look like I was like rich or something. I don't know. I don't think so. I think I look weird for Whole Foods. But for whatever reason, they treated me like I was actually belonged there. They were like, okay. They like accepted my money. You know, it's not like, oh gosh, where's this money been? I don't really know if we can accept this money, but I guess we'll accept it. Yeah, but, you know, don't really want to. I talk to people, you know, that they don't go to Whole Foods because the experience is so terrible. It's a terrible experience at Whole Foods. We go places where you walk in, everybody says, hey, how are you been? Hi, good to see you again, you know, and chat with you and line and nice and friendly and, hey, have a great day and we'll see you next time and, you know, just make you feel like you're part of the family, like fat mom and pop grocery store. You buy groceries, you want to feel that way because you're captive audience. You have to buy groceries, right? So they've got you. So, boy, you know, if they treat you like you're like some kind of a fungus, just like it kind of, you don't want to eat the food. It's terrible. Maybe the cashiers think everyone's idiots, the shops there. Like, what are these idiots paying so much for all this food? Like, so maybe deep inside they're kind of laughing, like, God, another idiot, you know, is coming through. And maybe that's it. Possibly, right? It's all mental. You know, everything's mental. So, you know, you can drink your wheatgrass as much as you like. But it's totally mental. Everything is totally mental. There's nothing outside of the mind at all. Nothing outside of the mind. Is this recording? Oh my gosh, it is. Can I even post this? Of course I'll post it. Is there anything I've not been willing to post? Yeah. It's, you know, very rarely. Stuff is just subpar, you know. Or just for some reason the Holy Spirit says no. So, okay, it's really, just didn't have it. But this is going to go up on YouTube. Maybe it'll be a YouTube classic. I don't know what the upper crust is doing in the world. I really don't. They're not watching YouTube. I have no idea whether they're probably sipping martinis or something, you know, and just who knows. If I ever see one, I'll have to ask them, what do you do with your time? Probably traveling a lot, staying distracted as much as possible. But I watched like surf videos this evening. It was raining, nothing to do. I watched a whole bunch of surf videos, and some of them were pretty good. And just, okay. Most of them are not that great, but the video of the surfers, it can be quite beautiful. And I don't know. Just kind of getting used to the different ways around the world. So there's Morocco, okay, there's Spain, you know, there's Ireland, and, you know, just kind of Tahiti, and just kind of getting used to all this stuff. Just so, for some reason, maybe I'll just be able to shrug it off. So, yeah, I know, just, you know, well, it's no big deal. That's good to be like that. You don't want to get hooked into being a teenage surfer boy. I'll stay 12 years old. I'll stay out of the water. Maybe I'll do a boogie board. I have a boogie board. I'll stay just a boogie boarder. Never even done it, but maybe I will. Maybe in a wave farm, I'll do some boogie boarding. Why not? Let's go to Arizona. I don't have one in Arizona. I don't know where they have one. Texas. I'm sure they have one in Texas. Let's go boogie boarding in Texas. So I have no idea what I'm going to do next. I never do. And really, that feels great. It feels great to have just simply no expectations at all for anything. That's spirit, because spirit is everything. There's nothing it can't do. So it doesn't have to have this belief system of expectations, like, okay, I expect I can do this. No, spirit is just spontaneous. There's this feeling of just always fresh, always spontaneous. It never attaches time to any experiencing. You see, of course, there is no time, so how could it attach it? But we believe there is, so we attach a belief in time to our experiencing, and that makes it stale. It gives it a stale feeling. So we could be experiencing this right now is totally fresh, except we're putting all these clouds, you know, the staleness, attaching this staleness to it. But really, we could just let go of that any instant. Is it still recording? I don't know. Maybe I ran out of batteries. Let me see. I hope it is. Ah, I hear it. That's great. It's still recording. Wunderbar. Yeah. So, the freshness is here. It's here. We just have to drop the belief in time, space, process, and form. And we will be experiencing, as it is, the fresh. It'll be fresh. It'll feel fresh to us, blissful, fresh. Just blissful is this freshness. No matter what we're doing, it's fresh. It feels fresh. So just like right now, no matter what we're doing, it feels stale, right? No matter what we do, it feels stale. So people are saying, I don't know. Is there football games coming up? Probably. Maybe, you know, probably, right? It's January. So, yeah, we're gonna sit down on the sofa in front of the TV and crack open a tall, cool one and, you know, got the chips and the dip and we're gonna live the life. And then, first down! Yeah! And, but it all feels stale. It all feels stale. Everything feels stale. So have another tall, cool one. It's sad. I mean, it is sad. It is sad to see this. You know, it is. It makes me depressed. It makes me sad. So holy cow, they don't have a clue. They're just, you know, it's like deja vu. Oh, every moment's deja vu. This feels stale too. You know, this feels just like the last moment. I thought, haven't I felt this before somewhere? Yeah, the last moment also felt stale. So all we have to do is just drop these false beliefs that something's attached to this moment. Because actually, nothing's attached to this moment. It's not that we have to detach from anything. It's not attached. It's already not attached. It's already not attached. So there's nothing we need to do. We just got to stop believing that there's something attached. But we outsmart ourselves because we say, no, I'm believing that I'm getting rid of this time. I'm detaching this time from the present moment. It's not attached. So if you're trying to detach something that's not attached, you're going to still feel stale. That's how we just keep tricking ourselves. Obviously, it's a device to delaying device. So don't do anything. We don't have to do anything. Give up the notion that anything has to be done as far as detaching anything, getting rid of anything. There's nothing to get rid of. Nothing's attached to this moment. There's nothing we need to get rid of. There's nothing we need to detach. Right? We don't have to do anything at all. But except there's nothing we need to do. And give up the belief that there's any obstruction at all. There's no obstruction present. And stop drinking the watercress, right? That's causing a problem too. It's very distracting. Maybe it's the cucumber in there. I don't know. Or maybe I didn't shake it up. No, it's all clumped at the bottom here. Oh my God. That's the all-time worst. Let me try again. Not the all-time worst. The broccoli juice was the worst, especially after like a week. God, that's horrible. I don't even know how they get that taste. It's the cucumber. I think they must have like juiced the skin of the cucumber is what I'm thinking. Oh, celery too. Lemon. Look at this mix. Lemon, celery, cucumber, spinach, and kale, and water. And watercress? Is watercress even in here? Let me see. It says watercress, so it must be in there. It doesn't list it, though. Let me see. Oh, yeah. As a matter of fact, it's organic watercress. And the topper is organic peppermint flavor. So you got the peppermint flavor mixed with the lemon and celery and cucumber skin and spinach and kale and watercress. Whoever made this is an absolute genius. Yeah. I want them as my personal chef. To throw in that peppermint flavor, that just absolutely makes it horrible. Undrinkable. Maybe that's the whole key, is you're drinking something that's undrinkable and you think, I'm really detaching time for me now. This watercress is going to detach time and space and process and form. If I just chug this, I will be enlightened. Because it's so terrible that even time doesn't like it. It's like a detox for time. Time will crawl away. But time's not attached, so let everything be as it is. We don't have to drive anything away. Nothing's attached to this moment. Nothing's ever attached. Ah! Starting to come down a little more now. This is pretty cool. Ah, man. I was doing my golf swing on top of a Bosu ball, inverted, with the flat part up. The Bosu ball, I'm telling you, I'm starting to figure out how to use it now. It is really cool. I mean, if you want balance and core on a different level, that's how to do it. So I'm practicing my golf swing and holding the finish on the Bosu ball and then moving around, and it was so taxing and tiring and difficult to keep my balance, just straining the entire body. Yeah, I just say, oh my gosh. You keep doing this, these kind of workouts, and you'd be able to hit a golf ball upside down. Erof! You say Erof! Instead of four, you'd say Erof! Hit it backwards, I don't know how, but you can do anything. And I'm practicing all these surf moves on the Bosu ball, crouching down like you're in the barrel, grabbing a rail, leaning this way, carving turns, and then going back and forth, and just everything. It just absolutely hammers your body. It really does. So I'm getting like a surf workout without being in the water, actually, except for the paddling. So someone told me he attaches a rope to a fence and goes in the pool. His board's attached with a rope, and then he paddles in the swimming pool. And that's how he builds up his paddling muscles. Well, if I had a pool, I'd probably do that. I guess we could get like a little plastic pool, huh? And jump in that. Yeah, it's possible. Get like a 2-foot pool, put the surfboard in, tie a rope to a tree, and practice paddling. Yeah? Could do that. Paddling is the name of the game. One of the names of the game. But anyway, I'm getting like, I feel like Joe Surfer right now. I feel like Joe Surfer. Because I'm just carving, in my mind, I'm just carving. I'm Kelly Slater, just carving all this stuff. And catching my balance in the most amazing ways. And leaning this way, and the Bosu ball, you know, tips really radically. But the edge hits the ground, but you can stay on it. Even though the edge is on the ground, you can practice staying on this, and your body's like all sideways, and you know, at an angle, severe angle, and you're moving like this. And you know, it gets a workout that you just don't get any other way. Bosu ball, BOSU ball. It's pretty cool to do it. I've taken a long time to kind of warm up to it, but now I'm starting to see that this could really be an amazing workout tool. And it's like a lot of things, right? It takes you a while to warm up to it and figure out, you know, what's the best way to use it and actually start getting up to speed on it. It might take you a year, 6 months, a year, who knows? You might have something you just don't use for a while, like that foam roller I've had for years here, the 36-inch one, and it's the first time I really got into it. First time, I just said, you know what, today's the day, I'm going to try it. And now I see, oh my gosh, as I start to fall off of it, I can put my toe down or my heel down and stop my from falling off. That's fantastic. So I can really work it hard that way and not even worry about follows along. And I'm sort of walking back and forth on that. And I'll try, yeah, you know, in a surf film today, I saw this guy do something. I said, why don't people do this? He did switch foot in the middle of a wave. First time I've ever seen that. I said, aha, you see, somebody is getting it. So he did backside on a wave. He did this backside turn. He got to the top of the wave, and he just immediately switched foot to front side. He's 180. He just went 180 degrees on the board. So now he was facing the wave face instead of with his back to it. I said, there you go. I mean, you should switch foot in the barrel. I want to see somebody start switching foot in the barrel. Why not? So I'm going to work on switching foot like that real quickly. And then I saw Kelly Slater do a clockwise 360 on the face of a wave. I said, there you go. That's what I'm saying. You should be doing that. That's the second guy I've seen doing that. And so he can do that. And you know, it's awesome. And then there's a floater in the tube, you know, as it goes back into the breaking part of the wave on a 360. It just floats back into the wave. I said, that's beautiful, man. Beautiful. So, just get your body in balance. Get your balance, okay? If you do one thing this year, physically, get your balance. Don't walk. Waddle into 218 like a dinosaur, because you'll get hammered. The world's looking to hammer you. It's hammer time. Like those big waves, that you know, they're going to hammer you. Now, if you really got great balance in any angle, you feel strong, your body's really lithe and can recover. When you're in that white water, you've been thrown upside down, and you know, you come out of it and you feel pretty much okay, right? You have that sort of that flexible core strength that balance brings to you. Well, psychologically, you need that sort of a flexible core psychologically to handle the waves of commotion. Nazare, is that how you pronounce it? I believe not Nazare. Like that, the most commotional wave in the world. It's going to come after us. And so we need this core psychological flexibility and strength and balance, getting used to this really Dharma King Dharma, you might say. The Dharma King non-duality that we have here, it's It's a real workout, psychological workout, actually. That we need to get familiar with it. Familiar, so we have that strength there. Remember, say, I'm not going to settle for any, you know, second best. I'm not going to settle for second best. I'm not going to get pulled into some sort of non-duality that is just, you know, mental. I'm going to just keep practicing no conclusions, draw no conclusions, full stop in the wow. Everything's wow. And keep practicing that. And go for it all. And as you keep practicing that, you get stronger and stronger psychologically. So when the big waves hit, you know, you can handle them. You're not, you say, okay, well, all right, I've been through plenty of white water, just getting hammered, like, you know, it was really bad. So I survived. I don't know how. I wasn't strong enough. I was young. That's how I survived. But when you're older, don't count on your youth, okay, to save you in terms of. Just when you're young, you just feel I can do anything, right? But when you're older, you better make sure that you're in good shape, and you better feel youthful, and you bet your mindset better be youthful, your psychology better be youthful, and having a body that's the core, there's core flexibility there is very, very helpful. Don't worry too much about sculpting your body or you know, big muscles or anything like that. Core flexibility with balance training. It is the fastest, best way to help your psychology. So just don't just do nothing in terms of preparing. You have to get after it somehow within this year. So it just has to be a year of utmost urgency. Don't say, well, I'm too busy. Excuses no longer work at all, okay? There's no excuses now. I don't want to hear any excuses from anybody. That's just basically saying, you know, I'll just worship stupidity and hope it works. That's what it's saying. And it doesn't work. And in trying to worship stupidity and hoping it works, you're going to get mentally ill. Guaranteed. It's not maybe, it's for sure. And start self-medicating and just go down the same stupid road that we've all gone down before so many times. The same stupid road. How stupid is that to go down the same stupid road? Well, it's worshiping stupidity is what it is. It's being loyal to stupidity, trying to worship it, trying to get it to sanctify us when we're already perfect. So you just have to realize that it's either go down the same stupid road again or stand up and say, you know, I'm not going to let that happen. And so I'm just going to start doing some simple stuff. And just gonna start doing it, that's all. It's time to get in shape. Just like if you're out of shape or in the diet, you realize today's the day, and it starts today, and that's it. So I know that feeling, and it's an exhilarating feeling when you start. You say, oh my God, I started. And right away, you feel great about yourself, right away. You get the jitters too. You say, oh my gosh, I actually started jogging, or I started dieting, that's it. Now I'm going to keep it going. Yeah, it's easy. But suddenly the future becomes very different, right? It's your expectations that are shocked. You say, oh, I don't know what my future is going to be like. Well, it's going to be wowish. It's going to be very wowish. Absolutely, it will be. And wow is wow. You don't need to define it. It's wow. So you feel comfortable, relaxed. I said, well, you know, I feel comfortable in my own skin. I certainly do. I feel comfortable with myself. I'm very wowish, and everything is very wowish. And my take on everything is wow. And my mind is calm. It's not all agitated, searching for answers. You know, I got the answer is wow. I already know the answer is wow. Oh boy. Whew. So there's nothing better than using your moments to get it done, right? To really do what you need to do, to say goodbye to being loyal to stupidity. Nothing better, no better way to spend your life. And you'll feel that way. And you don't have to worry about, well, what's going to happen. No, I still have fun. I have more fun than I ever did before, actually. But it's all within the context, you know, the right context. So be like the preteen. They're not decadent. You know, preteens are not decadent. They're not wicked-minded. They're not, you know, they haven't gone. You know, it's usually the teenage years you start getting weird. The 12-year-old is not weird. There's a big division between preteens and teens. And so the two are like separate species almost. I mean, they don't really relate very well, right? If you have like teenagers and you have younger kids, they're like, you know, who are you? You know, I mean, you're just a kid. I'm a teenager. And so, very different kind of situation. So it's better to be a preteen. It's better. Better. So why settle for second best? Why be a teenager when you can be a preteen? As far as your outlook goes. 12-year-olds have this, you know, wide open outlook. Very, very much in the moment. They're up for anything, you know. They're just, it's wonderful. You could be like that. You can be like that. And you work at it, and then one day you say, hey, I'm different than I used to be. I can see that. I'm a little bit different. Now, actually, I feel I like myself better this way. But it's not, you know, there's not like some sudden transformation or anything like that, no. So you have to work at it. Every day, just keep working at it, and a year from now, guess what? You will realize I'm not the same person I was a year ago. That is for sure. I'm much better. I'm much better now. I feel way, way better psychological balance. Physical, psychological balance. And keep working at it. Because keep working at it. Let's just stay positive here. And stay away from these drinks. Oh, gosh. Original superfood. That's just not good. No. Dilution time is coming up. Coconut water dilution time. Chocolate protein powder. Something. Is gonna, yeah. I'll, how many smoothies I got here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 5. It's like 6 days worth of algae, drinking algae. I don't know. I'll see you back here next week and see what has happened. Maybe I'll turn into Jack and the Beanstalk or something. Jolly Green Giant. Maybe this is the elixir of immortality we've been waiting for. And fairy dust. Fairy dust. It's transformed. Transformed. Transformation. I'll be transformed whether I drink this or whether I drink, water. The transformation doesn't come from what you drink. From what you think and what you don't think. I recognize that absurdity is absurd. Nothing's attached to this moment at all. Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Okay. Well, it's not going to rain hard yet. I'm still waiting for the rain. It just, again, has been totally overhyped. Ah, that's sad. It's a snoozer right now. It's really a snoozer. So before it rains heavily, I'll get into all this electronic equipment inside. And maybe, I could empty these drinks into the gutter, I might get fined for emptying watercress juice into the gutter, into the storm drain. We don't want the fish swimming in that stuff. It's toxic for the fish. Especially the cabbage juice. You're prohibited from pouring the suja cabbage juice down the gutter. Only I'm sure in Palo Alto that would be prohibited for sure. Yeah. You can't even pour water down the storm drain in Palo Alto. I think it has to be like organic water to pour down. You gotta filter the water before you can pour it in the gutter in Palo Alto. You have to have an inspector come out and certify that it's certified organic filtered water, and you can only pour so much down your gutter. But hey, it gets him through the day. It gets something. It's something to get through the day. But we have a little different way of getting through the day here, don't we? We absolutely do. We absolutely do. Okay. I almost became a Palo Alto. I lived in Los Altos for a couple of years, which is right next to Palo Alto, and it's all kind of one. But Palo Alto's kind of we've got a little different trip going on. But everybody's thin there. It's weird. Everybody's thin. high metabolism people, I think. Type A, high metabolism. Let's measure everything. Let's label and measure and categorize everything. And then teach our children well to do the same. Analyze, calculate, measure, figure, label, define, conceptualize, evolve, progress, succeed. Yeah. And they even got this little farm. They helps them out, helps them do all those things. The farm, Stanford University, the farm. It keeps them toeing the mark there. Yeah. So they don't backslide into realization. I wouldn't want to do that on the farm and give a bad reputation to the farm. Thank God my dad dropped out of the doctorate program at Stanford. He said, forget these people. They're knuckleheads. They don't know anything, which is true. Otherwise, I would probably have to toe the line. Barely. That would have ruined my life for sure. Because I need to be a Stanford man, going for tenure, and I have to act like I'm a son of a Stanford man, and Stanford doctorate, and have to toe the line, That would have ruined my life for sure. So there's another great thing my dad did. He said, how are you going to keep them down on the farm, you know, once they've seen Perry, you know, well, we couldn't keep them on the farm. He said, no, I'm going to the city, folks. So he delved into it deeper, which is great. He pushed the Dharma experience. He did his best to live a Dharmic life. And you could say that he did live a Dharmic life. You try your best in that direction. You could say that's a Dharmic life. It's not a Dharma kingish life type of thing, but still, oh God, that's a bad mix coming up. You know, you don't want to say, oh, hi, I'm Dharmic. You want to actually, you know, just keep grinding away at it. Like meet Mr. and Mrs. Dharma. People call themselves Dharma back then. They gave themselves the names Dharma. What's your name? My name's Dharma. And what's your name? My name's Karma. Okay. But really, it's about drawing no conclusions at all, isn't it? So I was asked to say, okay, you know, you need to be an example, so you have to say something. But prior to that, I didn't say, oh, I'm Dharmic or something like that. No, it's just I'm suffering and I'm working at it. Let's take a look at the mind. Let's take a look at the mind. Let's practice properly. So it's all about practicing, you know, full stop in the wow, no conclusions, allowing the lightning flashes of clarity to take place and just saying, wow, there's no world at all. It's never existed. Never existed. And just keeping your stride as all these experiences come. And work for the Dharma kings so you don't like just freelance it. Freelancing is tough because what's the choice? It's tough. You can try to be some guru, freelance being a guru, but that's very problematical, actually. Or just kind of live your life, you know, live the life. You know, some people do that. But for me, I'd rather work for the Dharma kings and let them tell me what to do. Because I don't want to freelance it as some guru. No way. Forget that. I mean, even if you're enlightened, I wouldn't want to freelance it. I don't understand these gurus freelancing it like this. Just what? I love the humility of the Tibetan masters. They bow to their teachers and just give homage to the lineage and just, you know, down talk themselves and denigrate themselves. Say, I'm nothing. You know, I have no attainment compared to my teacher. I'm just a complete idiot. And, you know, all praise to the grace of my teachers. And I'm, you know, just trying to, you know, shed glory upon them. And the way that they, you know, stay humble about it all is really great. It's great. Very effective. And some of them have like 30, 40 teachers, so you know, this really. And many masters, you know, they meet them and get empowerments and they feel these are some of their gurus. So they're very, very ecumenical in terms of having, you know, many teachers. They get truth from these various sources. That's how it is. It's very common. Very common. So the freelancers we have in the world become famous, some of them, a few of them. But are they more enlightened than like the, those in Tibetan Buddhism who are much more lower key? No, they're not more enlightened. They may not even be, you know, quite up to par, if possible, right? So it's interesting, the different styles. And I just try to ask, you know, your will, not my will, but thy will, and try to do what they want me to do. If they want me to put my face there, say, well, you know, okay, it's no big deal. Maybe some people, that'll help someone. It'll help be helpful. If it's helpful, that's fine. Bottom line is, we wake up in the morning and we go to the fridge, right? And you open the fridge and there's your, you know, original superfood. And it's like, oh my God, I've got to drink that today? Yeah, right? So you better feel fresh. You better feel fresh. You know, you feel fresh, you don't have to worry about this stuff. Because whatever you drink, whatever you do, everything is going to feel fresh. It's going to all feel good. So, it doesn't matter what happens. It all feels great. It all feels fresh. There's nothing that doesn't feel fresh. So that's what we're going towards. That's the goal, really. It all feels fresh. And people say, well, you need to mature so it feels stale. Don't need to do that. That's just delusion. It's always fresh. Why do we need to delude ourselves? I mean, for what purpose? For the fun of it? I've had enough fun of that. Because it's weird? Yeah, I had enough weirdness. Because we need to sanctify ourselves? No, we don't. That's just mental conceit. So there's really no purpose to it at all, except just mental conceit, arrogance, and, you know, whimsicality. All which are fine, but I'm just not interested in any of that stuff anymore. So it's just a matter I'm not interested in. Okay, so how are we doing? Pretty great. Okay, wonderful. That's it. How do I stop this? Same old way. Okay, you never know what happens next, right? Freshness. I think maybe I'll wake up enlightened now because I've got all this good green freshness in me. And nothing can stop it. It's rocket fuel. Well, enlightenment rocket fuel. Maybe I'll market, you know, some drink. I'll go out and mow the weeds and juice it and market it. Say, enlightenment rocket fuel. Yeah, that'll be the next big thing. Get it at Whole Foods. It's gonna be $11.99 though. Do you feel like you're getting something really good? It's the most expensive drink in it. Oh boy, this has got to be it. It's gotta be it, right? It's gotta be it. It can't be something my mind, it can't be the mind. It's gotta be like the body, huh? Gotta treat the body. Oh no, it's the mind. Trust it, it's the mind. Everything is in the mind. It's all the mind. It's not anything else. The body is just imagination of the mind, okay? It's not something else. The body doesn't have a mind. The body is the mind. Everything's the mind. Everything is within the mind. So, that's all there is to it. Hallelujah. God be praised. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, the Dharma Kings, Manjushri, Padmasambhava, Langchampa, Jamyang, Kyentse, Choki Lodro, Shri, Anandamaya Ma, the Queen of Wow, and Ramana Maharshi. Okay? So, thanks to all of them, and all their wonderful friends, and all their wonderful helpers, and all the rest of the great Dharma helpers throughout history. And we thank everybody who has contributed to the Dharma throughout history from all traditions, because they've all helped us. They've all helped us. They've all have a role in this. They all have a role in this. How cool is that? So, and all of you, thank all of you. You all have a role also in this. Absolutely all of you.